हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी अनदर सरफेस ट्रीटमेंट प्रोसेस दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग। एज वी नो व्हाई वी आर डूइंग द सरफेस ट्रीटमेंट, इन विच इफ वी आर डूइंग द सरफेस ट्रीटमेंट सो दैट द सरफेस ऑफ मटेरियल वी हैव टू मेक इट बेटर इन सम वे, लाइक मेकिंग सरफेस मोर करोजन रेजिस्टेंस, wear resistance. Like a metal surface treatment is any process that affects or alters or add to the surface of a metal part. So this treatment seeks to perform a variety of functions. Though corrosion resistance is the most commonly used, each type serves a different purpose. Among that surface treatment process, we are going to see this electroplating. This electroplating process is of a process of applying a metal coating on another piece of metal or another conductive surface through an electro deposition process. So in this electroplating process that uses electrical current to reduce dissolved metal cations so that they form a thin coherent metal coating on an electrode. So by using this image, you can see the metal cations are forming, which they are treated on the another surface to get a inherent properties. So in this electroplating, the deposited metal becomes part of the existing product with the plating or coating. Electroplating is used in jewelry making to coat base metals with precious metals to make them more attractive and valuable, and sometimes more durable. So it is a applications of metal coating to the metallic or other conductive surface by an electrochemical process. So why we are doing this electroplating? What is this purpose? Some of the purpose of this we can get it as appearance, to get a good appearance to the product, then protection, either corrosion resistance, wear resistance, to get the special surface properties to improve that, and to enhance the engineering or mechanical properties. For that purpose, we are doing this electroplating surface treatment process. As we know that most of the materials require an exterior finish to improve the look of the material and to protect it from the environment. So this surface finishes can be applied numerous methods like brushing, spraying or dipping to enhance hardness, durability and rebuild surface. Among that, this is the electroplating process. For that we are using this. So we can do this electroplating process by using following the four things that we are going to see. So this is the electro example or how this process is carried out. We can see the sulfate ions are formed and copper ions are formed. This sulfate ions are formed and copper electrode, or which can be collected by this copper ions and brass electrode in the electrolyte solution. So this chemical or electrolyte which contains one or more dissolved metals, salts as well as other ions, that permits the flow of electricity. So this, due to this electrolyte or chemical, because of that the flow of electricity is formed and the ions can generate and it can be go into the surface or electrode. A rectifier or electrical device that transforms alternating into direct current supplies a direct current to the anode. So the battery that is, or it is act as a rectifier, and oxidizing the metal molecules that comprise it and allowing them to dissolve into the solution. Then the anode, the positive terminal or positive charge metal for the coat, here the copper electrode, which may be in a soluble anode form or in an insoluble form such as titanium, platinum, carbon, lead or steel, can be used. And a cathode, that is negative charge article to be plated, where electrons are stimulated to form a film of non-ionic metal via the chemical solution to the target object, that is anode. So from the cathode to the anode, the reaction will take place and it is coated on this anode. So what are these methods of electroplating? These four things we require, and these four things are used in this method of electroplating. One is a barrel electroplating, then rack plating electroplating, vibratory plating electroplating, then reel to reel electroplating. So we are going to see one by one what are these methods and how they are operate to get electroplating. First one, barrel electroplating, in which the barrel plating method is an efficient and relatively low cost method of electroplating. Here what we are doing, parts and components are placed inside a barrel that slowly rotates while it is immersed in a metal plating solution. The electrical contact is made through the use of danglers or centerless bars that are located inside the barrel. These danglers or center bars are kept in this barrel and the electrical contact is made through this. This electroplating method is usually recommended since high volumes of parts can be plated with uniform coverage. In this process, barrel electroplating, we can plate or do the surface treatment for the high volume of parts with a uniform coverage. Next one is a rack plating electroplating process, in which the process used for large, complex or fragile parts and is excellent for producing selective deposits. So this is the picture of rack plating, in which the rack plating method, parts are hung on a rack that is then submerged in the plating solution. So this rack you can see on this picture. On these pictures, the part which are coated, these are kept or hang, and all this rack is submerged in a plating solution. The metal hooks or bands are used to hold the parts in place as well as provide the necessary electrical contact. So the hooks or bands which are used where the parts are hung, this can be used for the making the electrical contact to complete the electrolytic process. Then vibratory plating, in which the process used when the parts are very delicate or may bend or disfigure during the tumbling of the barrel plating method. So for that purpose we are using this vibratory plating electroplating process. In this procedure, operates using a basket with a metal button contacts and a vibration generator. For this process we require the vibration generator. These parts are immersed in the plating solution. The vibrations that are generated cause the parts to move delicately around while making contact with the metal buttons located at the bottom of the basket. So though at the bottom of the basket you can see this look metal buttons, so there they are making the contact and the parts are vibrate due to this vibration generator which are using. This particular method of electroplating has an excellent throwing power and can quickly yield high uniform plating. So by using this vibratory plating, we are used for giving the quick yield highly performing uniform plating. Then reel to reel plating, in which it is an efficient and economical process which allows for select deposits of metal. So this is the picture of reel to reel electroplating process. This reel to reel plating process can plate strips of manufactured products or reels of raw material before they are stamped into parts. This starts by loading the reels onto the derailing station. So derailing station you can see, and then by using a capstan system, the product is fed through the various electroplating process, and at the end of the line is take up system which dispose the material once the appropriate metal finish is achieved, in which multiple reels can run with the use of an accumulator, which facilitates a smooth transition between them. So this is the reel-to-reel electroplating. So what is the effect of electroplating? While using this surface treatment process, what it gives the effects? It changes the chemical, physical and mechanical properties of the workpiece. If you use this electroplating process, it possibly changes the chemical, physical and mechanical properties of the workpiece which are coated. We can see the example of chemical change when nickel plating improves the corrosion resistance. An example of physical change is the outward appearance, that appearance we are getting on the surface where we are using this process in a jewelry making. So there is getting the appearance and improve the durability. And mechanical change, which a tensile strength or surface hardness which is required in tooling industry can be changed. So where we are using this electroplating? Widely used in industry, coating metal objects with a thin layer of different material. We can use in a various industry, also used in making inexpensive jewelries. Also, electroplating increases the life of metal and prevents corrosion. So there we are using for chromium plating is done on many objects such as car parts, bath taps, kitchen gas burners, wheel rims and many others. So as a chromium is very corrosion resistant and thus prolongs life of these parts can be improved. So there we are using this electroplating operation. So here we have seen a surface treatment process, that is electroplating, how this operate, what is its principle, that we have seen. If you like it, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Click on bell icon to get more notification. For this, you can see the surface treatment playlist in the description box. Thank you very much.